Now we're catching up to Ray Aki as he closes in on the Card Sound Bridge, leaving Biscayne Bay, closing in on Barnes Sound. Ray's been enjoying this 36-foot deep impact center console powered by triple Mercury Verados, and I know he's got a brand new deep impact on order. So let's check in with the guys at Boats Direct USA to find out what's going on with new models from Deep Impact. Video of the week here for Boat Show TV, and also for those of you watching the Key West Poker Run video, this is a feature because Boats Direct USA is one of our sponsors for the Key West Poker Run. Stu Jones here with my guest today, David Pease, who's the general manager for Boats Direct USA, which is the mother company, the mothership, if you will, for these three brands that you build here, David. Deep Impact, as well as Blackwater Boats, and of course, the Ocean Hawk line. We've got new models from both Blackwater as well as Deep Impact, and you've got a nice also a nice Ocean Hawk that is real pretty, got some nice color and some big power. Deep Impact, a lot going on. What is going on with that brand and with new models there?
When Mark Fisher purchased Deep Impact, due to his love for the boat, as you know, that new right. $399 Poker Run edition that he has built, decided to purchase the company and decided we could build it better and retooled the entire boat. The new $399 boat will be both cabin model and open with a what we call a console cabin mm-hmm. underneath the open deck.
Right.
However, it won't be like any of the other guys. It's gunnel to gunnel. It's huge. It's functional. It actually you can sleep in there. It's a beautiful design. It will be introduced this week.
Now talk about this new stylish hardtop too. Not a T-top, an actual fiberglass molded hardtop, right?
Yes, molded hardtop, very modern design, very new, very cool.
Okay, so lots going on with Deep Impact. Now let's talk about Blackwater. What's going on new there? We just did a photo shoot for Blackwater. It was the video of the week. A couple of weeks ago, we had four Blackwaters. We had a great boat ride out there in Biscayne Bay.
Fantastic.
Didn't get any better than that. Talk about what's new with Blackwater now.
Well, you know, Blackwater brand has really taken off over a period of time, and most recently with the combination of Eugene Urarte and Mark Fisher, the marketing has really paid off and we are selling them left and right. I just delivered one to our first client in Bermuda. We have three different deck cap designs now, a tournament edition, a sport, and a sport fish, which is a beautiful combination of the sport front end and the tournament back end, so that the family version has really serious fishing amenities.
Let's talk quickly about, you know, obviously you've explained to me that the boats are being built here under this factory, under one roof. The same quality materials are going into all these brands. The same experienced technician, crew of technicians, really, and a guy who's been, Eugene, who's been building boats for a very long time. But what is it that's different to you between a Deep Impact customer and a Blackwater customer?
Well, primarily, Stu, if you look at the traditional lines of the Deep Impact, the very dramatic body line, our slogan is sexy. The boat is beautiful. It isn't the same client that buys the Blackwater. Blackwater has a more straight, traditional line that everyone in the market loves. It's looking at that type of a center console for both sport cruising and fishing. It can be both. The hull is designed for both. If you want the boat to be a tournament boat, no problem. Or a sport for just recreational Florida Power Boat Club runs.
And not to leave the Ocean Hawk line kind of like over in the corner, because it's been one of my favorite boats, the Ocean Hawk 33. We've got a brand new one here, rigged with some really big power, twin 350s. And again, I think that kind of lends itself more to the traditional boater, but it is a performance boat.
It's definitely a performance hull. The hull has a lot of history behind it. And then, of course, we have the new deck cap design and a new helm and some new configuration that kind of matches the quality of our Blackwater Deep Impact production. But that is actually a 25 degree at the transom boat, very fast, nimble. That's a lot of fun to run that boat.
Just to recap before we sign off, where can people find out more about all these different boats?
Our primary retail location is at mile marker 98 Key Largo. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, we are found, we have a very strong presence on the internet. Sure. Several different websites. You can Google Deep Impact Boats, you can Google Blackwater. All of them will come up under Boats Direct.
And we're going to go sell some boats now, right?
Absolutely. Headed to the Fort Lauderdale International Boat Show first thing in the morning. Boats Direct USA will be there.
And we'll be there to join you. And for those of you who are watching for the Key West Poker Run, Boats Direct USA, of course, a major sponsor with this event every year. Thanks, Dave. And Thanks to the gang here.
We'll see you at the run. I'll be running a new 36 cabin, metallic bronze, beautiful new boat. You'll see it at the show.
Back to the Key West Poker Run as we rejoin Ray Akee from Miami in his 36 deep impact as he crosses Barnes Sound to Key Largo. Oh, and here's another one of those beautiful scenic money shots, real high and wide, as we see the boats making their way through the Card Sound Bridge and turning across Barnes Sound. This will be their final leg as they approach Key Largo for the lunch stop at Gilberts. Now let's say hi to Curtis Watkins from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, here in his 40-foot skater called Team Disruptor. Now, Curtis has been on a bunch of runs with Florida Powerboat Club, but he put his boat through the shrinker. He had a 52 big, huge skater cat and said, you know, it was just too big to haul around. So he put it in the shrinker and brought it down to 40, and he said he loves the new size. I'm thinking green. We're all about green here with Todd Werner and the new Statement 380, a bling boat all the way, I got to tell you. Todd is very proud of that. Statement, of course, again, one of our sponsors for the Key West Poker Run, a very highly respected builder here in Florida. Nick and Todd have been pushing out some beautiful boats, and we've got Craig Berry in the factory now helping out. But Todd, this is his new baby. It's a triple Verado-powered 380. A lot of bling, a lot of lights, and a lot of cool paint. Love it. Now it's time for a closer look at this brand new 42 Huntress, Johnny and Don Weems from Destin, Florida. I said earlier that we saw them this summer in Destin at the Emerald Coast Poker Run. The boat was docked at AJ's, but it's a brand new boat for them. Five Mercury Racing 350s, a nice setup, a beautiful paint job. And he calls it Thor because he kind of looks like Thor if you've seen him. He's got that long blonde hair, but nice to have you guys here with us on Key West. Catching up with Louis Sotero from Miami in this classic 94 Top Gun, powered by Chief Engines. Long story short is the boat name. Louis Sotero, a great supporter of the club, got Christina and his son Louis Jr. on board. Let's welcome Team Nasty Habit, a 42-foot cigarette. That's Albert Terramana from Ohio. He's got Captain Bill Mercer with him along board, who maintains the boat. This boat is always looking great and running strong. It's got 1075 sterlings in it. And wife Jill is not on board, but she takes care of all the arrangements. So she's on board in spirit, right? Good to have you guys. Thanks for coming back. Let's welcome back Bob Berg from Florida and Team Artemis, 50-foot Nortec Super V, powered by triple Ron Potter 800s. Of course, Artemis has become pretty much a household name around the Florida Powerboat Club, attending pretty much all of the poker runs last year in the 2015 season. And one of his big claims to fame is winning that Sexiest Crew Award time and time again. Good to have Bob back. He's headed down, going to be staying on his yacht, the program, down in the Key West Harbor. Hey, ladies, you guys having fun? Now let's say hi to Chris Kinney and his gal Gabby, who came all the way from Lake of the Ozarks with this 38-foot Donzi ZR smash and dash. First timers for the event. They said they heard a lot about it. It was a bucket list event, and wow, what an event it was for them. They plan on doing more events with Florida Powerboat Club in 2016. Now we're catching up with George and Shannon Arduous in their 44-foot MTI Team Mayhem. A 2013 44 with Mercury Racing 1100. So not exactly airing the boat out right now because we're in a critical area with a lot of traffic, so they've had to slow things down. So maybe we'll catch them running fast a little later in the day. Slowing the pack down now. We're going to have to just take it easy as we get into Jewfish Creek here. We're in Barnes Sound, and there's Jewfish Creek with the Skyway Bridge in the background, Key Largo. So this is the point where everyone's just going to have to pull back on the throttles and get the lines and the fenders ready and get ready for the big raft up at Gilberts. So, of course, we still have a long ways to go. This is only one-third of the trip so far as we visit here with Chet and Cindy Huffman, came all the way from California in Waynuts, their 43 Nortec.
There's a brand new statement. That's actually Jeff Campbell's new 380 statement. There's a big Apache from Miami, and there's our PowerQuest friends again from Michigan. So you can see there's a real variety of boats all catching up to one another here as we close in on Jewfish Creek. Good chance for the helicopter to fly back now into the bay waters and catch up with more teams as they cruise on in and across Barnes Sound. This is Mark Waddington from Nebraska, a 52-foot outer limits V-bottom, a fast redhead. I kind of want to say they're from Lake of the Ozarks because, of course, that is where the Redhead Yacht Club is, and that's where their outer limits and cigarette dealership exists there on Lake of the Ozarks. So good to have you back on Key West Run. Now we're catching up with Brett Meneyer from the Performance Boats Group, also running right behind that Outer Limits, all part of the same family. This is a 42 cigarette, brand new boat, powered by Mercury Racing 1350s. Literally just came out of the factory a few days earlier. Let's welcome Alex and Leslie Fruth from Illinois in their Enough is Enough 46-foot Outer Limits. 5-year veterans of the Key West Poker Run, but it's their first time in their 46 Limited. What a nice looking ride. Now we're catching up with Daryl Turner from Texas and Team 4Play, a very classic 50-foot Nortec Super V with four engines. If you do any poker runs in Texas, you're going to see Daryl. He's been very active with the Tops Club for as long as I've known him, which is probably going on 15 or 16 years. But good group of guys there with the Tops Club. Good to have you back, Daryl, and hope you're having fun on the Key West Poker Run. Getting into another one of these little congested areas as we once again arrive here at Jewfish Creek, probably a half a dozen or more boats slowing things down just to make their way safely through Jewfish Creek. There's Rich Stone in his 38-foot cigarette, Top Gun. And there's Warren Tillerson in his 40-foot Nortec Roadster. Got his lady on board as they're heading into the lunch stop. But you can see the conditions are holding out quite nicely today. There's our Florida Fish and Wildlife patrol boat on duty. And another close look at Alex Fruth there in his big 46-foot outer limits. And looks like they are just winding things down. Hey, ladies. Get the life jackets off and getting ready to get some sun. This big skater just pulling off plane here, getting ready to pull into Jewfish Creek as well, along with this 45 cigarette. That's Larry Hill in the Maximus. Still catching this team at speed. This is Jason Bourne from Mass. So it's 42 Outer Limits, Bourne's Auto Center. Their first time on the Key West Poker Run. Looks like everyone's color coordinated in their white tees with their blue life jackets. Hey guys, high five to the entire crew for wearing your safety vests. Say hi to Larry Hill and the gang on the Maximus. And here's Jason Bourne and his crew again, first time on the Key West Poker Run. Look at that, all eight of them, white shirts and blue life jackets. Good stuff. Once again, everybody just chilling out here as they make their way into Jewfish Creek. So by just the length of this segment alone, hey ladies, just the length of this segment alone with all of the boats arriving into Jewfish Creek, it gives you an idea of the magnitude of this event. Because, you know, we've got the drone flying here and the helicopter hovering around for sometimes half an hour, 45 minutes at a time, and the boats are still flowing in from Biscayne Bay, making their way into Gilberts. So obviously we're gonna have them racked and stacked at Gilberts. The smart guys will go around the backside. You can see a few guys did that. They're docked there right at the boat ramp and over in on the backside. So remember that Gilberts does have deep water docking if you follow the beach all the way around. And for the rest of you, we're stacking them up about 8 or 9 deep. And this is something that you're really only gonna see on the Key West Poker Run and certainly only on the Thursday departure. But there's still a lot of space because some people didn't take up all the rows, and there's still a lot of guys who didn't take the option of going around on the backside. So remember that when you go to Gilberts, there's still a lot of opportunity to find your own spot where you don't have to be rafted out so deep. I want to thank again our Florida Fish and Wildlife Police presence, as well as our Miami-Dade Fire Rescue and our safety and paramedic teams, because these guys provide the very much needed first responder presence that we need for this poker run. The gang at Gilberts rolling out the red carpet, fueling up the boats, giving us a great lunch stopover. Remember, we still have about 110 miles to go. So for many of you with those big, thirsty engines, especially these like boats like Gold Rush, which has four 1100s, you know that they're not going to go more than about 80 miles without needing fuel. So let's get back inside to the tiki bar while these guys are getting the boats all prepped and checked over, and see how everybody's doing, because they're serving up a big lunch here. If you don't want to eat the buffet, you can still order off of the menu, which is nice. But for the most part, this is a real spectator-friendly event with all the who's who of the industry. There's Skip Raver hanging out with Johnny and Don Weems, and there's Team Maximus getting some grub here at the big tiki bar. There's music playing, there's a festive vibe, there's a lot of bikinis, and there's a lot of people that are saying, hey, we've arrived in the Florida Keys, and this is why we do it. And on that note, it only makes sense to give you guys a little bit of eye candy for the rest of this lunch stop, and that's what we've got going on with Courtney and Louisa, our two models who went with us all the way to Key West. So along with all of the pretty ladies that are on board all the Poker Run teams, we brought along some FPC girls to keep you guys entertained. Our newcomer, Louisa, from England, lives in Miami Beach. And, of course, Courtney, many of you know, who's been with the club for about 4 years helping us out on these poker runs and at all of the boat shows. It's always a big spectacle here on the docks at Gilbert's, so bring your iPhones, bring your cameras, get some pictures, and send them home to your buddies back in the snow because they want to see what you guys are doing on the Key West run. It's not just those big, thirsty, high-performance boats that need fuel. So does our Robinson R44, as our pilot, Lewis, fuels up the Robinson, getting ready for the second leg of the photo flight here. We've got the boats firing up here at the dock at Gilbert's and pulling off one by one as we're going to turn and head south on Blackwater Sound for the next leg of this fabulous run through the Florida Keys. Once again, the magic of the drone is bringing us these shots like we've never had before, because we could never really get a helicopter down this close without blowing you guys right out of your boats and soaking you with salt water. But now with this little tiny drone, we can get in close and get in tight, and we can really capture all the action and excitement of what these runs are, especially during these staging moments when people are getting ready. They've just had lunch and they're getting the boats out onto the waterways, because that's when you hear the roar of all that horsepower in one place at one time. Say hi to Mike and Angela Goldbaugh in their 38-foot Donzi. Veterans of the Key West Poker Run have done this event with us many, many times, and good to see you guys back. They're big supporters of poker runs all over the country. So we're going to let the drone pilot just roll here as he gets all of these teams pulling away from the dock at Gilbert's. And you can see what a great variety in terms of the types of boats that are on the Key West Poker Run, and certainly all the different states and locations that they come from. Once again, to recap, over 31 states represented, 10 countries around the globe represented here on this Key West Poker Run. I love this shot as this Nortec gets up on plane and the drone follows and actually turns and looks down at him and then back at the pack. This is quality video footage, guys. It doesn't get any better than this, and that's why we're loving these drone pilots who, by the way, Travis Nellum, who's flying this drone today, is doing a fantastic job. Lots more boats to come. Now we're in Blackwater Sound as he positions the drone here just on a stationary location so the boats can just throttle up and pass by as they head south. This is a part of the run where we kind of have to change the tempo and change the way that we do this next 25 or 30 miles, because it's so critical to maintain safe navigation through these upper keys. So to get everybody to take off in a big pack is not the way we do it. And you can see that everyone is just staggering the starts and one by one throttling up here, putting a lot of spacing in between the boats. You guys have really done a stellar job of keeping this event safe. Bikini bottoms.
shoes underneath, but the boy's heart still skip a beat.
Now we're at about the hour and 50 minute mark of this video presentation here of the Key West Poker Run 2015, and you all know that there's still a ton of video footage to come. So what we are going to do is just slowly break away from this first disc, and we're going to give you a few highlights of what's to come. Because now, remember that we still have the entire Thursday run. Oh, look at that Outer Limits. How nice is that? We still have another 110 miles heading south. The helicopter is going to follow us all the way to Key West, because Lewis, who's flying in the R-44, he's actually on assignment with Superboat, so he's going to be shooting the powerboat races on Friday. So all of us are arriving at the Key West Poker Run Village, and most of us are staying in the historic Seaport, or the Galleon, or the A&B Marina, or the City Marina. Some of you are at the sponsor dock, but we've got a lot of activities planned with the Key West Poker Run Village. Friday night is the sponsor appreciation party. Saturday all day, we're going to go out for a fun run. Saturday night is the big poker run party here, where we're going to give out a bunch of awards. And offleaseonly.com has provided us with a brand new 2015 Camaro that we're going to be giving away to the top team. So I want to thank all of our sponsors and all of our participants. We're going to wrap up disc one here and send it out to everybody. And you're going to soon be getting disc two, which is going to total out to close to 4 hours for the Key West video presentation for the 2015 edition. So thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed disc one of our four-hour video presentation covering the 23rd annual Key West Offshore Poker Run. This is Stu Jones. We'll see you on the next one.